Hello everybody, myself Nazmin. I'm a speech language pathologist working at Prayatna Center for Child Development. For past few years, parents had been coming to us for the consultation for their children with a primary concern of speech delay in them. As part of assessment, while looking to their histories, one of the main environmental factors contributing to their speech delay were the same. And this environmental factor is nothing but exposing them to electronic screens like smartphones, televisions, tablets at very younger age for a longer duration of time than the recommended guidelines. According to World Health Organization, the recommended guidelines for exposing to screens are: children between the age of 2 to 4 should be exposed not more than 1 hour per day to screens, and children under 1 should not be exposed to screens at all. How many of you watching this video are following these guidelines to your children? The answer will be a very big no. Because if you had been to any social parties or any of the birthday parties or any of the parties where social gathering takes place and where therein interaction should go on, we can see children from 6 months and above are there with their own screens where there is no interaction taking place. So in this video, I would like to share few red flags in their speech and language development when children are exposed to electronic screens at very younger age for a longer duration of time. What are the red flags? The first and foremost red flag is regression in speech and language development. Few parents came to me saying that my child is 1.5 years of age and he is not able to use words that he was using during his first birthday. Yes, there was a regression seen in him. So the first question I asked them was he exposed to screens after the age of 1? They said yes, till first birthday they didn't give him screens, but now he had been exposed to screens for longer duration or he was left with screens for a longer time. 1.5 is an age where there we can see speech spurt in them, where they start to speak new words every day. This is a time where they look through their environment, look at their parents or caretakers and learn how to use language to communicate with others. So at this point, if you had introduced electronic screens to them, they only learn from the television without getting a proper feedback from them. Like when we interact on one-to-one with a parent or a caretaker, they always get a feedback from them saying what they are getting is right or wrong. For example, when they say about this is an apple, the feedback that they get from the parent is like, yes, what you said is right. But when they are just into a one-way medium, that is to the television or the smartphone, they are not getting any feedback. They just watch what is displayed on the screen. The second red flag is poor expressive speech, no functional communication or no intent to communicate in them. A parent came to me saying that his child is 2.6 years of age and he is well versed in his vocabulary, that is something more than his age. He knows all the colors, not only the primary colors but all the colors, and he is very good in saying all the numbers and all the alphabets. As a profession, I was very happy to hear that, and I asked them what is their concern then. Then they were like, even though he is in full bag of vocabularies, he doesn't know how to communicate that to another person. For example, he had been to a store and the child was very hungry and he wanted to have an apple from there. And he knows what is an apple and how it is, but he was not able to say his parent or say his father like, Dada, I want apple. Then what is the need of knowing so much of vocabulary in them? So when a child is exposed to screens at very younger age, they learn so much of things and so much of learning happening in them, but without knowing how to generalize these concepts in outside environments, that is at least calling their parents for their own help or saying I want something. These things are restricted in them. The third red flag is cartoonish language. Most of the parents came to me saying that my child speaks quite good, but he has a cartoonish influence on his language. And whenever he is left alone, he shows so much of irrelevant talks. And if you keenly observe to his talks, All the talks include most of the cartoon characters that he is exposed to. And few children even speaks in the intonation pattern of a cartoon that are exposed to. If you had been seen few cartoons on the media, there is kind of cartoons where their matching activities takes place, where there is a green ball which has happened to on one side and the child is made to match a red ball to the green. And when a red ball comes to the green, the sound that is made from the media is like which says no. And when a red ball again comes to a red ball, it says matching is done and says So the child that had learned from this media is like is for a no and is for a yes. And the child had started using this kind of communication for communicating with others. The fourth red flag is poor pragmatic skills. Pragmatics is the use of language in a social setting. And this skill develops in a child only if they get life experiences from their caretakers or parents. And when a child is exposed to electronic screens, they are not getting any chance to have a social interaction with another person, so these skills will be limited in them. Nowadays, electronic literacy is important, and it is equally important to reduce exposure to electronic screens for young children. If you really want to reduce, you can get back to our videos wherein our rehabilitative psychologist had given tips to reduce exposure to electronic screens in them. After following these tips, if a child is still exposed to electronic screens even for a minute, try to make it fruitful by following these tips. Label the objects of the content that they are exposed to. Ask them questions about what they were watching and help them share their experiences based on the things that they had come across in the screens. As said earlier, if these red flags still persist in your child, go and consult a speech-language pathologist at the earliest, because according to the research, timely intervention helped them to outgrow their speech and language difficulties. Thank you.